Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about the social changes that came into existence in Europe. So, European society, after the French Revolution, faced a lot of social and political problems. Now, industrial society. So, what is their demand? How did they respond to the demands of the people and demands of society? These are things that we are going to discuss. It was time when new cities came up and new industrialized regions developed. Railways expanded and the industrial revolution occurred. You know, we call Bombay as industrial capital of India because so many industries have come up near to Bombay. So the business hub of Indian economy. So like that, in Europe also, many cities being developed due to new technologies and new developments. You know, communication and transportation are important factors for an industrial center. So the railways expanded. Railways have started. Come on. And cities. I think you might have studied in 7th class how a place becomes a city. A place becomes a city when so many people come to that place and settle down. So when so many people are coming to their place and settle down, naturally that's it, that place need education institutions, shops, hotels, transportation facilities, like that, earning dollars. It can be by any reason. It can be by a religious center. It can be because of an industry. It can be because of a capital. Many reasons a city can be developed. So like that, when in the European society, so many cities were being developed. And railways were expanded, you know, railways were started by that time. And industrial revolution, you know what is industrial revolution? Sudden increase in the production of materials. So a revolution has taken, the revolution in the word meaning is to keep in mind, because we come along so many times the word of meaning revolution. Revolution means a sudden change. In anything it can be. So in the production is from 1 liter to 2 liters. If the milk of a cow, it goes, it is normal. But if 1 liter to 20 liter or 50 liter, suddenly change is taking place. A cow is next generation cow is able to give 60 liters of milk from 2 liter or 3 liter. Or 10 liters to 60 liters. That is called the revolution. In agriculture field, we have 1 acre of the land. In that 1 acre of the land, we were producing 10 quintals of wheat. If this time we are producing 100 quintals, we call it revolution. So that is the revolution. Industrial revolution has started in Europe. Okay. Industrialization brought men, women, and children to factories because so many workers were needed in the factories. So all of them came, and naturally many work in the factories, some are in the home, some are going for some other job. So like that, so many people have come to the cities because of industrialization. So that is it. Many people who are living in villages, who are purely depending on agricultural activities or herding animals, they left those activities and they are coming into the cities. So naturally, they have more desire, more thinkings. Work hours were often long and wages were poor. long hours or 12 hours, 13 hours. We know now, as per the International Labour Organization, minimum 8 hours work always should be there. But at that time, it was 12 hours, 13 hours, sometimes 14 hours also, people used to work in the factories. So, work hours were long, often long, and wages were because supply of the workers were plenty. If one person is ready to work for 8 hours for 100 rupees, other person tells, I am ready for 90 rupees. So, naturally, when the supply is more of the workers, the wages were paid very less. Because one person tells, I am not ready to work for this way, other person will be ready. So, the wages were less at that time. Unemployment was common because chances were not, so many jobs were not available. If plenty of jobs are available, so many people are going for a job, different kinds of jobs. Even there is no person to get for a job, then the salary will go up or the wages will go up. Unemployment was common, that's a great problem in any society, especially in Indian society. We can say unemployment is a very drastic problem, particularly during times of low demand for industrial goods. And people are not purchasing a material. Whatever is produced in the factory, people don't want that. The material is dumped, then the people who are working in the factory will be thrown out of the factory. They will have no job. So, that problem occurred. It's a great problem. Housing and sanitation were problems since towns were growing rapidly. Everybody should get houses to live. And when the houses are constructed, it should be clean and neat. It's a problem. You know, slums are there in Bombay. If you go to the slum area, it is so much dirty and unclean. It's very difficult to live in that area. But the greatest, one of the latest survey report has wondered, has created this history in India of COVID. India is able to face COVID because we are not having so much neat and clean facilities. Such a great invention. That's the reality also. Okay. Liberals and radicals searched for solutions to these issues. So housing problems, sanitation problems, food problems, unemployment problems. And because of all these things, this group of people, liberals and radicals, began to think, what should be done? Who will do this? Who will take care of it? How to manage these things? So discussions and debates among the people were taking place. All industries were the property of individuals. Private individual was having the thinking of their property. It is not a government factory, a factory of the individual. Naturally, an individual will think about the profit. That is any kind of industries. Now we know India. In India, so many industries are run by private companies. So all the private companies will have their aim to get profit. Their aim is to get profit. So that is what we see here. Liberals and radicals themselves were often property owners and employers. These liberals and radicals, because they were from the upper strata of the society, they were called bourgeoisie group of people. And they were, many of them were factory owners. Property owners and employers. They were factory owners and landlords. Opposed to the privileges of the old aristocracy and had by birth. They were factory owners, they were rich, but they were not getting the social position as they wanted. Because they were not born to the aristocratic families. So means socially high positioned group of people. The landlords of earlier period. So, these liberals and radicals wanted a share in the government, a share in the positions of everywhere. That is the demand. Now they began to think, how we can get the share? How we can remove the old aristocratic society and come to that position, because we are also rich. We are also having plenty of factories in our control, workers are in our control. Why can't we
be also made the rulers of the country. That thinking is creeping into the minds of the liberals and the radicals.
If freedom of individual is accepted, poor could labor and those with the capital could operate without a strain.
So they wanted liberty, complete freedom.
So what will happen if complete freedom is there?
The poor could labor, they could sell their labor freely.
Anywhere they go, good practice will come up, everything they can do it without any restrictions. And those with the capital could operate without restraint. I am having plenty of money, I can start any factories, I can do anything stupid. Now we know to start a factory we must get a license from the government. If that license is not there, any factory can be started by anybody. So things will come very fast. Now we have to go to government office, get the permission, and so much of bribing and all problems are there for the getting a permission to run a factory. So many will stop doing anything. So they wanted that system where no restrictions are there. That was the thinking of liberals and radicals.
Working men and women rallied around the liberal and radical groups and parties in early 19th century. This men and women, these ordinary people, also began to think, okay, as these people are speaking,
if that happens, we will not get good salary. Good factory will be opened, many factories will come up, many factories are coming up, many will get employment. So we would be very happy.
That was the thinking of men and women of that time. After 1815, Giuseppe Mazzini, an Italian nationalist, conspired with others to achieve this in Italy. So that individual freedom, individual things and everything, a revolutionary ideas were brought up by Mazzini. He is from Italy.
And Italian unification is taking place one because of his leadership. One of the reasons, main reason of
Italian unification that we study in 10th class. So unification of Italy in 1870s.
You see, we are discussing in 1815, unification takes place in 1871. So many years late.
So an Italian nationalist conspired with others to achieve this. So means freedom, liberty, equality, all those ideas are booming around in European society. Everybody thinks about it. Everybody wanted such kind of things. They want individual freedom. So that is the demand in European society. So socialism in Europe. Now we'll discuss about the socialism in Europe. So what is socialism? That's first we will discuss.
A political and economic theory of social organization which advocates that the means of production, distribution and exchange should be owned, regulated by the community as a whole.
Means of production and distribution. What are the means of production? Raw materials, land, money, industry, factories, all those things as a means of production. Distribution means transportation facilities, road, anything. Nowadays road also is privatized, you know, we have to pay toll. So that's a privatization.
So then everything should be owned by the community, not a privatized. Here they are, that is socialism. Earlier, road we could use. There's no toll should be paid by anybody. Anybody could use the road because it was made by the government. Now government has given to the private individuals.
It is capitalism, just opposite to socialism.
Socialism is political and economic theory, social organization which advocates that the means of production means anything that is used for producing, that's a means of production.
Okay,
raw materials, workers, everything, distribution and exchange should be owned and regulated by the community.
Either the community or the government, somebody should welcome. That is the idea of socialism.
A transition social state between overthrow the capitalism and a realization of communism. Now, previously they were thinking about the capitalism. Now the thinking is into the socialism.
By the middle of beginning of the or end of 19th century, we can say. By the end of 19th century, the thinking in Europe was about socialism. Everything is equally shared. The society is high. So there will be no rich, no poor. Everybody will have equal share of the wealth of the country. So that was the idea. It's a good idea. But implementation problem. That we will discuss later. Okay? So that is socialism. Understand? Should be owned, regulated by the community as a community should regulate. So here there's an idea. It's a transitional, it's a period from the capitalism to communism. Socialism is a transition between period, they say. Communism is the rest, where everything will be managed by community. An utopian theory that is has come into existence. Communism is another one, what you see. Communism is a philosophical, social, political, economic ideology and movement whose ultimate goal is. So what is communism ultimate? Establishment of a communist society, namely a socio-economic order structured upon the ideas of common ownership. You see here, this is the main thing. Common ownership. Complete society's owner. If I am having this pen is not my property, it is of the society. The society will tell me, should I have this pen or not? The society will decide, should I go for what education? The society will tell me, should I go for plowing the field or should I go to office in the morning? Everything will be decided by the society. So that kind of society. That's meaning. Common ownership of the means of production and absence of social classes. There is no rich person or no high class, no low class. Money and the state. There is no money also. No, I mean, because everybody does their thing. Money is to keep my properties. So no need of money. Everything we live in a good society. And at last, there will be no government, no state. They say no need of government because people are very good, friendly, nature. No fighting, no frictions, no disagreements. A heaven-like situation. That is what the state is. Even in heaven, there is God. So, according to their ideology, no government is needed, no state is needed. That is the communism, without a state. A situation where everything is very good. An ideological creation that occurred in Europe during this period. And that's known as communism. Everything will be shared equally by community. So, these are imaginative situations that are there in Europe, that ideological thinking they are trying to put into reality, into real practice. That is the Russian Revolution. Okay, thank you very much.